What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're going to take a look at Helldivers 2 here on the Steam Deck and the Legion Go. The Ally won't be in this one as it is on RMA, but the Go will handle our Z1 Extreme testing for this game. So anyways, it's definitely been interesting. This game is definitely hooking me. I'm having a good time testing it here, and I wanted to take a look at performance for the deck and the Go, so let's go ahead and get into it here now. On the Steam Deck, it was only working on desktop mode before, but then today there was a hot fix and it is working from game mode, so I was able to launch and run everything from game mode with no force compatibility either, just running everything default here. Now, as far as the settings, we're going 800p, and then you can adjust for your render scale. We'll be in full screen here as well, and VSync is turned off. Now, render scale, I'm pretty much going to use quality or balanced when it comes to the 800p here, because we are CPU bound a lot of the time anyways. And you can see as I toggle through performance, we'll go to like 54, just sitting still here in the ship, ultra performance 57. And then if we scroll all the way over here and get to ultra quality, back to quality here is 47. Ultra quality will be around 44. So, you know, typical 2, 3, 4 FPS difference depending on what you set here, just sitting still to give you a general idea. And again, quality or balance is kind of where I've found to be the sweet spot here on the deck for the 800p. Because again, not really a GPU bound situation for the most part. And just low on the preset here with motion blur, depth of field, bloom turned off. And, anytime I try to tick up any of the settings, even anti-aliasing or anything, it does start to hurt the performance. And when things get kind of very busy, I don't really want that happening. So I'm trying to maximize the performance we can get here. So anyway, 800p, low preset, RS balanced, 4 gigs of VRAM set in BIOS. Seems to work out pretty well here for Helldivers. And actually, I'm pretty happy to see the launch weekend or day one type performance here for Helldivers to be so decent, because we do get a lot of games come out that just aren't running that great. And even though we're going to have some frame time hiccups and issues here, and we're going to dip down into the 30s from time to time even with these settings and that type of thing here, it actually runs pretty well and feels pretty good to play, and on the smaller screen looks pretty good. It might not look great blown up and being captured, but on the smaller deck screen, especially the OLED screen, the game looks really good and feels decent to play. Now, going up to quality, of course, we'll hit things a little bit more on FPS when the GPU is actually getting hit and the CPU is not the binding issue. But for the most part, not a huge difference in quality and balanced, although quality will give you a little bit better picture as you're playing. So it's just kind of up to you what you want to go with there and what you're trying to get. But there's only so much the Steam Deck can really do with the game. But what I do like seeing here is that there's probably some room for improvement, right? We've had mods for games like Starfield and Pal World and other games that work well on the Steam Deck, and sometimes with mods and patches and different things from the publisher, from Steam, from the mod community, we can often see a 5, 7, 10 FPS increase or better frame times or all kinds of things that can happen. And I do feel like Helldivers 2 has that room for improvement. It seems to be well reviewed, well received game. I'm having a lot of fun with it, so hopefully it will get that kind of attention, and if it does, we'll test it out again and check out those kind of things, if there's mods and further improvements with patches, optimization and that type of thing. But anyways, I think it's running pretty decently here. At least we can stay above 30 FPS. You could lock 30 if you wanted to, but ultimately able to play Helldivers 2 here online in a group on the Steam Deck. So let's go ahead and get ready. We'll move over and we'll take a look at performance on the Lenovo Legion Go. All right, so over here on the Legion Go, we'll take a look at 20 watts, 30 watts, 1200p, 800p, 4 gigs of VRAM, and 6 gigs of VRAM, just to give a general idea of our performance here. And we'll start off with the 1200p. And again, I'm going to opt to be around the quality or balanced. Performance can also gain you a little bit here as well. Low on the preset, just like over on the Steam Deck, motion blur, depth field, and all that off. Yes, you can start to tick up a few of the settings if you want to improve graphics, but every time I really try to improve anything, when it got busy, I would dip and my frame rate would suffer. So it just wasn't worth it to me to do that. So that's why I left everything that way. And for the most part, I feel like I play the game between 38 and 50 FPS for the most part, pretty much no matter where I'm at or what I'm doing here, even on the 20 watts. And switching over to 30 watts can help improve some. Frame times are pretty good. We do get those spikes here and there, which we'll talk about a little bit more later when we take a look at the 6 gigs. But here on 4 gigs, 30 watts, RS quality, low preset, 1200p. Again, whether I'm 30 or 20 watts, I do seem to play between that 38 and 50 range, depending on what's going on. And I can go in here and move down to performance on our render scale. And yeah, it is going to improve things a bit for us here when it comes to our frame rate. But when it gets busy, you're still going to dip down. So here you are in performance, right? And we're just not pushing the GPU to its max. There's other optimization things here. Maybe it's not using all the threads the way we want, or whatever the case. It feels more CPU bound or resource bound, where we're not always pegging the GPU, which usually means something else is going on there and holding you back. So even with more wattage, or even with using performance or whatever the case, we kind of do cap out on our performance here with what we can really get. But even in different environments, the performance was pretty much the same as well with these settings, and not too much of a change. So I spent quite a few hours running around testing things out, and ultimately felt pretty good here on the Legion Go. So I do want to take a look at some other things here as well, which is going to be switching over to 6 gigs of VRAM. And I know a lot of people are doing this, especially with the 1200p or over on the Ally at 1080p, going 5 or 6. And I do wish we had a 5 gig option, because I hate to take more than 4 gigs from the system. I'd just rather leave myself 12, because by the time you boot in, you only leave yourself 6 to 8 for a game. So when I take 6, it really only leaves me, after I'm booted in, 4 to 5 gigs left for a game. But it does work pretty well here, and what I do notice that does kind of help us out, even though we don't increase frame rate, and like I said, we still are kind of capped out and not always pegging the GPU, you'll see we're using just over 4 gigs of VRAM most of the time, or that's what's allocated anyway. And it does take away that spike you were seeing a lot of times with the 4 gigs, that kind of high up quick spike you would see a lot earlier on in the video with the Go. So it does help with that. It doesn't fix all of the issues, but it does seem to help some in this game. So it's something you might want to try if you want to smooth things out a little bit more. But ultimately, 20 watts, 30 watts, at 1200p with these settings, you're still going to come down into the 30s. That's just going to kind of be the nature of the game. Now, taking a look at 800p here, 800p quality works pretty well. This is similar to over on the Steam Deck with the same low preset at 20 watts. Now, I didn't really bother going above 20 on this. You can sneak it up 22, 25, whatever you might want to do here for 800p. But the thing is, 800p just runs really well here. 800p quality, low preset, 4 gigs of VRAM, because I don't really need the 6 here. I did test it. It didn't help anything. So 4 gigs here when I was at 800p, and everything worked out pretty well. I can maintain a higher frame rate. We're still going to dip down into the 40s, but most of the time, instead of being like that 38 to 50, I was more 44 to 60 most of the time when I was playing. So definitely helped, and I think that for me, I would probably opt to stick with this 800p setting and play the game this way. Save me a little bit of battery power, decent on the frame times, high enough frame rate to feel good for the shooter, and it works out well. So 1200p looked nice, it works out okay. You can adjust your settings, run 6 gigs of VRAM or whatever, but ultimately here for me, 800p with the 4 gigs, 20 watts, not too bad of performance, just jumping into the game here. All right, guys, I think that's going to wrap it up. I mean, performance for Helldivers 2 here, just as it's coming out, is pretty good. I'm pretty happy with the way the state of the game, how it has launched. It's running decently enough on the Steam Deck and playable. It's running pretty well on these Z1 Extremes here, especially if you're opting for that 800p, 900p range and adjusting resolution scale. You can get some pretty good performance as well. And I'm having a lot of fun with the game too, which is surprising. When I first started, I wasn't that into it, but a couple hours in and it's really kind of gotten to under my skin a little bit, where I want to keep playing. But anyways, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one.